Why we eat what we eat is so important. And if you're anything like me, when you sit down to engage in the time-honored tradition of breaking bread, you're thinking of some random fact about the meal that's been placed in front of you. If you're not like me, if you're a normal person, then maybe by the end of this, you might have something to share at your next feast. On day one of our exploration of African American culture, entitled High on the Hog, let's look at the history of African American cuisine, or more commonly referred to as soul food. The term soul food was first coined during the Black Power movement of the 1960s. Soul food, as defined by Britannica, is the food and food preparation techniques associated with African American cuisine of the United States. Most notably characterized by the ingenuity of the chefs who were able to take meager rations and create the classic culinary masterpieces that we still enjoy today. I'm talking biscuits, black-eyed peas, Brunswick stew, butter beans, catfish, chicken livers,
chitterlings or chitlins, chow chow, collard greens, cornbread, chicken fried steak, crackling, fat back, fried fish, fried ice cream, grits, ham hocks, hog maws, hog head cheese, hot sauce, lima beans, macaroni and cheese, mashed potatoes, milk and bread, mustard greens, neck bones, pig's feet,
red beans, ribs, rice, sorghum syrup, sweet potatoes, turnip greens, and yams. Now, on that exhaustive list I just mentioned, I'm sure there are a few things that you still enjoy today. Even my most health conscious of health conscious people still like to dibble and dabble in the mac and cheese and yams combo every now and again. Soul food is most often associated with Southern style cooking, and slight variations in the aforementioned dishes can be attributed to regional differences brought about by forced migration, think selling of slaves to different plantations, and willful migration, think the great migration of Black Americans from the South to the North between 1916 and 1970. As we can imagine, the origin of soul food started where most things for African Americans started, on the other side of the transatlantic slave trade, on the shores of America near the Carolinas. In the journey, new foods, cooking techniques, and traditions like teranga, the West African ideal of neighborliness and hospitality, were introduced to America. Soul food culinary cornerstones such as black-eyed peas, okra, watermelon, and kola nuts were brought over and cultivated in the personal gardens of slaves on plantations. One of the things, a silver lining if you will, of this transatlantic slave trade was that it introduced diverse West African cultures and traditions to the amalgam that already existed in America. For instance, barbecuing meats and deep frying fish was a cooking technique that was used in West Africa long before the transatlantic slave trade. The melting pot, as some so affectionately call America, was already simmering, but as always, we brought the spice, or in this case, the rice. Now, as I mentioned, we're just scratching the surface. There are so many aspects to take into account when looking at the birth of what we now know as soul food and the impact of soul food in the formation of not just African-American cuisine, but American cuisine and culture at large. Take the kola nut, for instance. Indigenous to the western banks of Sierra Leone, literally the base of the American cult classic, Coca-Cola. Well, that and cocaine. If you're interested in learning more and reading more, of course you can check it out on my blog, thereeducation.blog, and I also have some sources linked below on some interesting pieces of literature by African-American culinary historians who really take a deep dive into the history of the whole thing. I hope you enjoyed today's content, and as always, share your thoughts and let's keep the conversation going. Stay tuned this week for some more African American cuisine related fun facts that will be shared on the blog. I look forward to seeing you next week. Peace.